All right, joining us now, David Bahnsen, founder and chief investment officer at the Bahnsen Group. Ed Keon, chief investment strategist at QMA, and that is a PGIM company. QMA, a PGIM company. Okay. And our guy, who's doing your branding? You have,
we have some experts doing that.
Yeah, exactly. And our guest host, Peter Buchvar, chief investment officer at Bleakley Advisory Group, which is usually his view on the economy as well, and a CNBC contributor. Now, see, that works. That really works for him. We know exactly. Anyway, so who wants to start? I mean, it was consensus, wasn't it? David, isn't this? I mean, this
yeah, is... it was in the big picture. It was consensus. But then you kind of look into the details, and I think net net, it would be an incredible act of spin to act like it didn't go more in the Republican side than Democrats. I mean, the Senate side, race by race, Nevada being the only exception. And I guess if I, as a Republican, were looking for real bad news, I guess the Southwest, you have to think that it's still going, continuing to move that other direction. Arizona's margins are tight. Nevada looks to be a flat-out blue state now.
The Cruz thing was kind of shocking.
The Cruz thing
but
was
he's in for
tight.
6 years. By 6 years, it could swing back.
Yeah, but I also think that the Cruz race is somewhat affected by, first of all, nearly $100 million spent. And obviously, he was coming from a sort of unpopular starting spot, even within the Trump support base. But overall, the consensus view is what took place, and I'm just looking for different things
mean
on the
for,
margin.
What's it mean for the markets? What's it mean for the economy? What's it mean for... we were just talking about who was friendlier to the bond market, and Chuck Gabriel said the difference. I mentioned a conversation Steve Sedgwick and Cutmore were having that maybe with the House and the control of Democrats now, maybe the economy doesn't do quite as well. It does well,
I
never, but it gets 2.5% instead
of
2%.
I'm not sure I agree with his comment, though, about the bond market, because I think we already know what the discretionary spending levels are going to be. That's not going to be moved much. And I'm kind of amazed by both sides of the aisle refusal to admit that we're just, if we want to actually move the needle on deficits, it's on entitlements. Nobody wants to touch it.
But in the short term, David, I can understand the argument that tax cut 2.0 goes away. And so as a result, you're not going to have that fiscal stimulus going into it. You're not going to have Treasury issuing quite as few, quite as many bonds to pay for some of those things along the way. I get that.
I do. And except for I think the size we were talking about there was not necessarily needle moving anyways.
Right.
And I do think one of the most interesting things to markets that Larry Kudlow is talking about, Secretary Mnuchin's talking about, they can do at Treasury Department level, not with an act of Congress. And that is that inflation indexing to capital gains.
Right. Can you speak, though, both of you, to the issue that Mr. Buchvar was talking about, which is the leverage that China thinks it has or doesn't have today relative to yesterday in terms of where this tariff trade war go.
Yeah,
that's to me going to be the overhang over the next couple months, one way or the other.
I would hate to think that my client capital was going to be affected by me being able to forecast how China's interpreting midterms. I'm not so sure how we're all interpreting midterms.
But they were certainly waiting for it.
But they were, and I really believe that we're in the same place we were, which is that both sides do not know what the other side's end game really is. I don't think China has any less or more leverage based on last night.
And you don't think there's new information?
Oh, no.
As a result of this. I mean, I think they were waiting for new information, either because they thought that the president was going to be...
If there was a sound rebuke of President Trump, that they would feel they had
more leverage. Or that they really didn't have the leverage, in which case they were going to have to actually...
No, that's a fair point, and obviously that did not happen. I don't think anyone's waking up this morning saying, wow, President Trump was really scolded. This is so far from a 2010 moment with President Obama.
And you have to buy into the whole supply chain disruption bearish story to think it's that big a deal anyway, because it's our domestic economy that's really kicking... took us right now. I mean, I don't know if China is front and center on it. That's not the one thing I would talk about.
The tariffs would be
concerned. But I would say Q3 GDP, though, the business...
Yeah. The Democrats like the tariffs. That's what's important.
But the business investment number within Q3 GDP, I'm one of these guys who really thinks CapEx has to be high. And I believe with that explosive CapEx in Q1 and Q2 coming down to practically zero in Q3, I do believe that was tariff related.
I guess I don't want to give...